Hi all, Cliff Cramp here. I've been asked to do a landscape painting in Essentials, Painter Essentials 7, and so we'll go ahead and get started. As you see here, I'm just kind of playing with composition. I'm going to do a reverse L composition so that the eye is moving from left to right, and then I'm going to have action moving from right to left to kind of cut against the grain. So you see this tree here putting together to block the viewer from leaving the composition on the right hand side. And what you see, basically my approach is shape, form, color, detail, but I'll line out a few things initially, and you can see that my thumbnails tend to be a bit chicken scratch. I can draw, but I'm admittedly a little bit impatient to get into the painting. So my sketch is really for composition. As you can see, I'm developing a lower third composition in that rule of thirds. So the focal point is going to be in the lower third. So I've finished the sketch and I am glazing over in digital watercolor about a 25% gray, and now I'm taking the digital watercolor new simple water brush and I'm bringing in some form to some of the foreground trees. So the whole goal in this process is to develop the composition and to develop a strong focal point. I find that the digital water brush allows me to set up my values very quickly. And again, I'm not going into detail at all, and as you'll see throughout these videos until we get to the last video, I don't zoom in. So I am approaching the painting all at once and trying to build the painting. So I just dried the initial pass with digital water, going over it again with digital water to continue to build the contrast of light and dark, and now to start to develop form. So I like to draw, as you saw, the sketch was initially a scratchboard tool, a very light gray value. Basically, I block most of the painting in with digital water. So what I did there is I just duplicated my layer and went to the layer function of multiply, and I did it again, and now I'm dropping the opacity down to create even more contrast within my values. So if I get the painting to a certain level of values, then I use what I've already done by duplicating the layer, selecting all, copy pasting, and then bringing it up to another layer, and then hitting it with a multiply function, layer function, and then dropping the opacity to where I like the contrast. Now if going into the painting with a opaque brush, the well, not fully opaque, but I really like the glazing constructing brush. So now I'm going to start to add a little bit more to the light and dark side, and this is where I'm starting to try to control edge a little bit. So my lighter side edges are going to be a little bit harder, and my shadow side edges are going to be soft. I'm always trying to play contrasts, light side, dark side, warm side, cool side, and we'll get to warm side, cool side, and temperature in the next video. But in this particular video, the main goal is to set the composition, set the focal point. Focal point generally is greatest area of value contrast, and then that's the area where I'll give the most detail to it. I can kind of see, I've added a kind of a little Viking ship in this semi-fine fantasy environment. I'm going for a swamp in this particular environment. So I moved it a little bit to the left. I'm still strong in the bottom lower third. And so I've kind of sped up the video a little bit, mainly because this is all just kind of the preliminary brushwork. I'm not really getting into developing a lot of detail. And in this stage, I started with my scratchboard brush in order to sketch out my kind of my roadmap And then I played a lot in digital watercolor, and then using the layer functions to enhance the values. And now I'm just going in and pulling in a little bit of detail, but I'm just defining the shapes a little bit more. And this whole process, sped up the video a little bit, but this whole process of this value study would generally take me about 20-25 minutes if I wasn't talking and worried about messing up the painting in a video. So I'll continue to develop the values and develop the focal point. Again, this is the early stage. Now, if I don't like this painting within about 30 minutes, I get rid of it. So here's another constructing brush, and this one is the particle brush, and I'm kind of just giving a hint of some of the foliage that might be hanging down from the upper part of the composition. I'm also going to have the composition fading into darkness on the upper side because I'm trying to develop a sliver of light moving from left to right to our main focal point of the tree and the Viking ship. And here I'm not trying to necessarily get the painting perfectly. I am trying to just set my lights, my darks, and my focal point. I'll make all the corrections as I build the painting up. And that's about good for the value study.